Good afternoon. Bonjour. Prime Minister Morawiecki, Mateusz, thank you for coming to visit us here in Canada. You welcomed me a little over a year ago to Poland, and I'm glad to be here welcoming you here today. 1 million Canadians claim Polish heritage, and 500,000 of them live here in Ontario, many of them in Toronto, so it's quite fitting that we be meeting here today. Before I begin, however, I want to take a moment to address the devastating wildfires happening across the country. Communities are being displaced. This is a scary time for a lot of people from coast to coast to coast. Minister Blair is working with provinces, territories, and municipalities. Our number one priority is keeping Canadians safe and making sure that they have the support they need. As you know, the Canadian Armed Forces are supporting, and I spoke with the Chief of Defence Staff this morning. We will continue to be there to support in whatever ways we can. Aux Canadiens touchés par les feux de forêt, on est là pour vous. On continue de collaborer avec les provinces, les territoires et les municipalités pour s'assurer que vous ayez l'aide nécessaire pour que tout le monde soit en sécurité. Prime Minister Morawiecki and I had a productive meeting this morning. At the top of our agenda was the Kremlin's brutal and unjustifiable invasion of Ukraine, which has redrawn the security landscape of Europe after decades of peace and prosperity. La Pologne est aux premières lignes de la violence et des atrocités commises par Vladimir Poutine et ses acolytes sur les plus de 8 millions d'Ukrainiens qui ont dû quitter leur pays depuis le début du conflit. La Pologne en a accueilli des millions. J'ai eu l'occasion de rencontrer des réfugiés lors de ma visite en Pologne l'année dernière. Le Canada a accueilli près d'un quart de million d'Ukrainiens depuis l'année dernière, en plus de fournir une aide humanitaire aux Ukrainiens réfugiés en Pologne et dans toute l'Europe. Mais on sait que la chose la plus importante qu'on puisse faire pour les soutenir, c'est d'aider l'Ukraine à défendre sa souveraineté. As partners and allies, Canada and Poland are working together to train members of the armed forces of Ukraine. Canadian Armed Forces members are in Poland right now, training them through Operation Unifier, Canada's training mission that, since 2015, has trained over 36,000 Ukrainians. Poland is also where CAF members have been training Ukrainians to operate Leopard 2 tanks. Earlier this year, we deployed Canadian Armed Forces members to support a Polish-led advanced medical skills training program for Armed Forces of Ukraine personnel. And just last week, we deployed more CAF trainers as part of a new round of military support to Ukraine. Poland and Canada are both also strong allies in NATO. In fact, Poland is a significant contributor to the Canada-led NATO battle group in Latvia, contributing over 170 troops to the mission. Depuis le début de l'invasion, le Canada s'est engagé à fournir plus d'un milliard de dollars en matériel militaire à l'Ukraine, ce qui comprend des chars de combat Leopard 2, un système national de missiles surface-air perfectionné, des véhicules blindés, des armes anti-chars, des armes légères, des obusiers M777, des munitions et bien plus. This is part of the more than $8 billion in aid Canada has provided to Ukraine, including economic support. Across Europe, we're seeing economic shifts in reaction to Putin's brutalities, including his weaponization of energy. Energy security is an urgent issue for Poland and countries across Europe. Like-minded countries around the world are working to build stable relationships with partners who have values that align so we can build resilient supply chains. This is about energy security, yes, but it's also about economic opportunities in the economy of the future, a net zero economy. Canada is ready to be the supplier of energy that a net zero world will need. Les entreprises canadiennes investissent déjà dans les énergies renouvelables en Pologne. L'entreprise canadienne Northland Power a conclu un partenariat avec l'entreprise polonaise Orlen pour construire un parc éolien d'une capacité de 1,2 gigawatts dans la mer Baltique. On renforce aussi le commerce déjà solide entre nos pays. Depuis que notre gouvernement a lancé l'ASCG, Le commerce entre la Pologne et le Canada a augmenté de 53% pour atteindre près de 4 milliards de dollars par an. Le travail qu'on fait ensemble va permettre de créer des bons emplois et de bâtir un avenir plus sécuritaire et plus prospère pour nos deux pays. I'm grateful to have been able to meet today and grateful to have such a strong security and trade partner in Eastern Europe. We're both steadfast friends and supporters of Ukraine. I know you met with President Zelensky just yesterday. And together, we are committed to coordinating and sustaining support for Ukraine around the world. En tant que démocratie, la Pologne et le Canada entretiennent des liens étroits qui unissent leurs économies et leurs populations. Et la rencontre d'aujourd'hui nous a permis de resserrer ces liens importants. Merci